Yeah, yeah. Are you not recording this?
Nope.
Actually, did I hear you say the other day you called Eric?
Yes.
Okay. And
probably, if you were paying attention.
There was a really weird thing that happens. I mean, this is what Logos does to us. It sort of drops stuff on us. And I don't know why I was doing this. It's the first time I'd ever watched any of, what's he called? Steve McRae. Do you know him?
I've seen stuff by him.
Well, I was.
I think I don't remember much.
I was. I was watching that, and he was doing a program with Chesh. They were like behind a judge's thing, as though they were judging people, judgment or something like that. It was called, and they were actually. It was all about them saying that they didn't trust Fight the Flat Earth with his. Qualifications, they said that they don't believe he actually has some of the qualifications he said. I mean, I don't know too much about it, but
Opposition 16.
We've had those sort of suspicions for a while. But in that, the guy was talking about having Brenda over and a I don't know, partner or somebody with him with called Eric. And that was like the second time I'd heard the word Eric. I've never heard it for ages. The only other one I know is Eric Morecambe. Morecambe and Wise.
Aha. Uh-huh. Yeah, I was just going to ask whether that was Wise. Yeah. But I think there are a fair number of Erics. It's
That's not you then, right? You don't know Brenda?
Nope.
Okay.
Okay, I've got Proposition 16 here. Do I start at the beginning or...
Yeah, go on.
This.
Read it out, let's to make sure you've got the same one.
Straight line from A, that's the tangent point, at right angles to AB, that would be the tangent.
To the right angles to the...
All outside the circle.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's true, right?
Unless you want to count the tangent point as part of the circle, but it's part of the circumference, okay? Okay, is there any of this other stuff important? Suppose it does not. I do not suppose it does.
Yeah, it's all.
Well, I'm willing
all important.
To accept that.
You can't just miss bits out.
Really? I'm not interested in the proof of that. I accept that, okay. The tangent does not...
Okay, so you accept then circle. That you cannot measure an angle down from the tangent point because you can't see. Because... It would cut the circle.
Where is that? Do I really have to read the whole thing?
Where's what? No, you equivocated the tangent as being horizontal. So therefore, the surface of the circle would be what you would call the surface of the water. And you would not be able to measure an angle downwards because the surface of the water would be in the way. It would cut...
wouldn't see, where, it?
The
where,
angle would
where
cut.
Where is this angle you're talking about?
You're the one that's talking about the angle, the grade. Do you not remember? Like, but by you having a grade, you make an angle. It's a triangle. When you're just talking about a straight line, there's no angles needed. A horizontal just goes straight and returns back on itself because it's a totality of the horizons, right? It goes all the way round and comes back to the same point with no end being higher nor lower than the other. That's what
is. There's a bit here about right triangles.
Yep. They're
therefore,
good,
the straight line, definitely. Was that the bit drawn from the point A at right angles to BA?
Yeah, you don't
not fall within the circle.
Don't do your editing to be doing this live. Live Euclid.
Where is your angle that can't be measured?
There's no angles in Euclid. You have to take it as a logical step, a logical statement.
But the angle DAC is right, therefore the angle ACD. Those sound like angles to me.
Sounds like the basis of algebra, doesn't it, Euclid, when you read it like that.
Okay, well, so he's got the proof that the tangent does not...
that no line, no line can be drawn below that tangent point that does not cut the circle.
Where is that? Proof.
It's a very, very good proof. But obviously, it depends whether you will understand
the geometrical
meaning behind it.
Into the space between the straight line AE and the circumference CHA. Okay. Another straight line cannot be interposed. Yeah, a tangent is stuck to the surface, so to speak. What did that have to do with your canal?
The horizontal.
Yeah, that's the tangent.
Did you say something about horizontals being at an angle to each other?
Yeah.
Well, didn't that just say that no other straight line can be drawn underneath it without cutting it? So that therefore means that you cannot have an angle from a horizontal to another horizontal.
No, it doesn't.
Of course it does. Shows you cannot make an angle downwards from a tangent because you can't do it in reality. Not possible. First of all, you have to assume that the surface of the water is circular, which obviously that isn't true. That's horizontal.
I don't think anything here agrees with what you're saying here. I don't see anything about drawing an angle from the horizontal. It says you can't squeeze a line in between the tangent and whatchamacallit, the circumference of the circle.
Did you just whatchamacallit?
That isn't
How long have you been holding that back?
What?
How long have you been holding the whatchamacallit back for?
Whatchamacallit? You mean the phrase whatchamacallit?
Yeah.
Or
whatchamacallit? Yeah.
But that's not really applicable anyways because
it's a great candy bar too. Whatchamacallit?
Yeah, whatchamacallit.
Really? Uh-huh. Yeah. I don't think they have them here. But Snickers and Yup and
have the geometry whatchamacallit where you're at. Not the camera.
Yeah.
Euclidean whatchamacallit.
Your horizontal is not going to be a tangent unless you put your outer level right down in the water, which probably...
Okay, so we can just deal with it being a line of even altitude then, all right? It's away from the surface. We can stop calling it a tangent. Brilliant. So it's just a horizontal line, right? Brilliant. We've done away with all of that other stuff. There's no need to call it a tangent, right? And then there's no need for us to bother with circular geometry.
But we can just do
away with that problem that you had.
It would not be a line if you're defining lines as straight. Because if it's got the constant altitude, it will be following the curve on the globe Earth.
A horizontal would follow the curve.
Who said anything about horizontal?
A horizontal made from the auto level at an even altitude, away from the surface, doing away with... any circles or anything. You can stop imagining circles underneath it, can't you?
Now you're presupposing the flat Earth, because that doesn't work on the globe. It's just a horizontal, dude.
Auto level is a tool for establishing a horizontal, right? Away from the surface because it is a surface of even altitude, isn't it? In fact, a water level also does the same. The tool... establishes a line of even altitude. We call it a horizontal condition. In the famous Merriam-Webster's dictionary, which I know you definitely like that dictionary, don't you?
Well, it's easy to remember.
Yeah.
The name of it. But I don't...
horizontal condition.
I never heard of that. But,
you know, I'll get it for you, just so you remember it for next time. Okay?
Yeah. Okay.
There you go. I'll do that. I'll put that one in there first.
But,
you're learning a lot, right, Hicks?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you thought you weren't going to learn anything.
For one thing, I find that if I Google horizontal plane, almost every result I get up is medical. A horizontal plane is a plane through the body at perpendicular almost. To the spine. That's not quite the way they put it.
Perpendicular. I like that. It's good. Always geometrical.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
Because horizontal and plane are both mathematical, aren't they?
I'm not finding any thing about horizontal planes on the Earth.
You see this here. If you look in the live chat, Merriam-Webster, you can check this up for yourself.
Yeah.
It says definition one, definition of level, a device for establishing a horizontal line or plane by means of a bubble in a liquid that shows adjustment to the horizontal by movement to the center of a slightly... Right, well, that's spirit level, right?
Yes, okay, I agree
brilliant.
That you can
fantastic.
Establish
so here we go for the next one. A measurement of the difference of altitude of two points by means of a level. Right, so that is what the tool does. It establishes a level and you measure the difference in altitude away from the surface, because the surface is called elevation and altitude is away from that. Wait a minute, Hex, I've not finished yet. This is a 1-2-3, right? A 1-2-3 system. So a level, the spirit level, is a tool for doing that, and then level is a means of establishing a difference in altitude. And then this is the one that you've never heard of before. Strange. It says number three, a horizontal condition, especially equilibrium of a fluid marked by a horizontal surface of even altitude. Water seeks its own level. So that's particularly talking about the tool, a water level, and the surface of the water level, because it's one body, establishes an even altitude. And they call that a horizontal condition. So, I mean, it's not really a medical condition or anything, is it? You know? It's like a condition. It's one of those things you could call it like a law, like a law of hydrostatic equilibrium to establish a horizontal surface of even altitude, like water level seeks its own level. That's what it means in that dictionary, isn't it?
Yes, but either that surface will only be approximately flat. Or, let's see, where are we going?
I don't think so. Horizontal condition. It doesn't say approximately or anything there.
Yeah, but most measurements and in most instances, we're only interested in for practical purposes.
Okay, well, so that really, one underneath it then. I know I've done 1-2-3, but number four says an approximately horizontal line or surface taken as an index of altitude again. And then that one says charts were arranged at eye level. So that the eye level one seems to be a bit of an approximate one, because how do you tell where your eye level is? It's just approximate, right? You're not actually measuring it. Whereas the other ones earlier, they're tools that establish a horizontal condition, not an approximate. No, only the eye level one. Because there's some people that keep going on about the eye level. They don't seem to understand what the word level means in relation to eye. It's a bit tricky, but we're going to do that. We're going to show people exactly how that works and how levels work and all of that. Sorry, you can carry on now.
Yeah. Yeah, well, these things are approximate. In most cases, we don't worry much about the small differences between a flat surface and the surface of the Earth.
The slope.
Curve flat. Of the Earth.
Flat or slope? Is that what you're doing?
No.
No. Oh, wow. Do you think you can... you don't think you can measure a curve, do you? Do you? I mean, I don't know. It's interesting. I've never heard of anybody that can do that. But do you think you
can? Not with a ruler.
Oh. Do you think anyone can measure a curve?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I
go
do.
On. How would you do that? How would you describe a curve first? Give us your best description of a curve. No?
I'm getting a little tired now. I'm not really interested in going around
my
in circles.
My missus
would
get knackered at trying to work out how to describe a curve either, actually.
You can't even describe a curve, Hex. Really?
He's getting tired. Don't trouble him. I mean, it's a tricky
straight.
Question.
Or plane.
Yeah, you can't curve straight? A plane.
Okay, surface.
Is the circumference of a square straight?
Well, no, it's four straight
that
lines.
That doesn't really work for a description of a curve, then, does it? Does a square describe
not,
a curve?
It's not a line, and...
It's not a line, now.
No, it's four lines.
Yeah, you were asked to describe a curve, and you said a line that is not straight. I asked you if the outside perimeter of a square was straight. You said no.
But it's not a line, is it?
Does a square describe a curve?
Does it describe a line? It's irrelevant otherwise.
A square? Yeah, square definitely describes a line, doesn't it?
Does it?
Yeah, it describes the square of the line. Wow.
Square of the line. Are you talking mathematics now?
Talking about a square. Yeah, what are you talking about?
I was thinking of geometry.
Well, we were talking about how would you describe a curve. Have you got people working it out for you? It's tricky, isn't it? I mean, like you argue for something all the time. And when
we
asked, haven't got a clue what it is.
We know what a curve is.
No, I know what a curve is. I also know that you can't describe it.
What difference does it make?
It's fucking hilarious, dude.
How would you describe it?
Oh, well. I would describe it by using a straight line.
That's sort of what I did too, since I said that it's a line that isn't straight. But how would you?
Well, how would you say, if I was to say I would use a straight line? You use something that isn't a straight line. That's crazy.
How do you use a straight line to define a curve?
Describe a curve.
Yeah,
do you want me to? I'll read something out for you. It might help you out.
I doubt that.
Well, let's see if it sounds familiar, right? And that a circle may be described from any centre at any distance from that centre.
Yeah, but a circle is not a generic curve. I mean, it is a curve, but... If I define a circle, then that definition is not going to apply to all curves. So I'm not defining, I'm defining a specific curve, but I'm not defining a generic curve.
So you would describe a curve by using a straight line. Well, I would anyway.
How?
It seems like I would by telling you the radius of the curve that you're talking about.
But curves in general don't have radii, do they? Or
yes, every curve has a radius that will describe that particular curve at that particular point. That's okay. Why we choose to describe the circle by a center point and a distance from that center. Okay. You should really have tried doing a little bit of homework. Just a little bit of the basics. So now, when you said you would describe it by saying it's not a straight line, and when I say I would describe it by using a straight line, do you want to choose your wording differently? Or
I'm still not sure what you mean by describing it with a straight line. Do you mean the radii? It's not a straight line. If you're talking about generic curve, you've got multiple lines, and even the circle, you can't just use a straight line. You have to take all the radii.
A radius describes the circle.
How many straight lines do you need to make a radius?
A radius doesn't describe a circle. It helps to define it, but you have to describe what you're doing.
Yeah, if you know anything about geometry or even took the slightest inkling, a circle's just a point mover.
Point mover?
Yeah. Because it can't really be described from the outside in any way at all, can it?
Right.
That's why you're struggling so much to describe it, because you haven't got a clue what you're talking about. You don't worry about it, though. You're not the only one. Loads of people. Everyone, in fact, everyone I've ever asked gets surprised at how to describe a straight line, and then how to describe a curve. It's something that's just pass you by. You imagine you already know it, but then when you go searching, there's fuck all there for it. There's no description. There's no idea. You haven't got a clue.
I'm more impressed by how good you are at avoiding explanations and changing the subject and
which explanations do you think that I am avoiding?
Well, you're definitely avoiding the acceptance of what globe earth math geometry physics.
Sorry, globe earth math geometry physics. Give us an example of some sort of
changing my mind. Physics, the fact that down is towards the center of the Earth, approximately.
Would you not call the surface of liquid water physics? Is that not like a physical thing?
It is a physical thing. It's not physics.
We just explained it as having a horizontal condition. And I'd suggest that that's provable also. I mean, it's up to you. If you think you can prove otherwise...
I'd also say that
a horizontal is a straight line.
Differences, well, basically, a water surface that isn't affected by other forces than gravity, downity, or whatever you want, is. Oh, I'm sorry, I've forgotten what the statement was. Is horizontal at every point? Yes.
Yeah,
but all these points, all these horizontals are not parallel with each other.
A horizontal is definitely a straight line and not a point, isn't it?
Well, I wouldn't say it was either. It's a direction from a point.
Oh. A horizontal is, a straight line. We did agree to that first. It's really weird that you've gone back again.
I don't remember
We said vertical and horizontal are perpendiculars, and perpendiculars is the relationship of a straight line to another straight line. And the formation of one straight line necessarily comes with all of its perpendiculars. Geometrically, of course. And also, vertical and horizontal are perpendicular. Like, geometrically explained, it's still straight lines, both of them. Vertical and horizontal.
Oh, at every point around the surface of the Earth.
It's a straight line. So every point on that straight line will be on that straight line. In fact, it goes all the way further on where you can say every straight line contained on a horizontal plane would be a straight horizontal line. Connecting any two points on a horizontal plane, right, would have a horizontal line on it. That means that every point is on that horizontal plane, and any two points joining anywhere on that horizontal plane would be a straight line that contained with the horizontal plane. So therefore, a horizontal straight line.
In theory, yes, if you can find a horizontal plane... And
we have tools for establishing horizontal planes, don't we? Called water levels.
No, you can establish horizontal at a point, and you can establish a plane which is horizontal at that point.
You really seem like you led by a model.
Well, so are you. You are.
I'm just led by a geometric model. Yes, my geometric model of horizontal being perpendicular to vertical is what leads my model, yes. So we can play.
But vertical and horizontal are not
geometric model dictates, if you want. Would you like to play my geometric model dictates?